married.
I've spent most of my career working in much bigger companies, so I can give some insights into, you know, what works and probably just as importantly what doesn't work as Tullow continues to grow in size and complexity. It's great fun working with a founder, CEO, and I think the term entrepreneur is overused. I mean, actually, there are relatively few entrepreneurs in British business, but Aidan is certainly one of those. And clearly his personality, his style, has really shaped the culture of Tullow, and it's played a major role in the success of the business. The board consists of the five executive directors, and we currently have five non-executives plus me as chairman. Its role is obviously at a high strategic level. The day-to-day responsibility for managing the business rests with Aidan and the executive team and the greater management team. But I think that really what the board is trying to do is strike the right balance between entrepreneurial risk-taking on the one hand and prudent risk management on the other hand. And we're also trying to get the trade-offs right between meeting the sort of short-term expectations that the market clearly has of a company like Tullow, whilst keeping a very clear eye on the delivery of the vision and the longer-term objectives. So it's that trade-off between the short-term and the longer-term. And I suppose the other thing is just trying to make sure that we don't lose sight of our core values, the things that have made Tullow successful as a business over the years. Again, is the role of the board to try and set the tone for the business. And as we, you know, continue to grow, as we continue to become a more complex organisation, it's sort of inevitable that we're going to have to introduce more policies and procedures and guidelines and so on.
Absolutely, because this is, I think, one of the key success factors here.
Clearly, legal compliance is absolutely critical, but I think much more important is that we are seen to be doing the right thing, keeping our employees and our contractors safe and healthy and safeguarding the environment. So I think we all have to take personal responsibility for that. But I think it's hugely important that we don't lose that personal touch. I think what we're trying to do here is to build the capabilities and the resources of a big company whilst trying to maintain that small company feel. The board can set the tone, the board can set the example, but ultimately we all have to take personal accountability, because our reputation depends upon the behaviour of every single employee, every single contractor who works for Tullow.